Hello, guys and gals, me Mudahar. And did Among Us discover time travel? Ladies and gentlemen, if it did, that's pretty sus. Yes, I had to get that out of the way, okay? Listen, every time I do an Among Us thing, I barely play the game. I just like looking at the memes and all the beautiful, juicy shitposting involved. Now, today's video starts off with a little history lesson. This is Griffith. Griffith or Femto, the fifth member of a massive group. Griffith is a character from the anime known, manga series known as Berserk. I don't know if there's an anime out there, but Berserk is a very popular anime manga from Japan. Now, why am I discussing a character known as Griffith? Well, if you look at him, he's the leader of the original Band of the Falcon. He and his mercenaries are able to end the Hundred Year War and bring peace to the war-torn kingdom of Midland. Following the desertion of his most trusted confidant, Guts, Griffith basically gets into a wild set of shenanigans. Now, I don't want to start this video off with a history lesson, because why Griffith is important is today's Facebook character. Now, this is a Facebook user by the name of Griffith Femto. I'm not actually doxing anybody, believe it or not, ladies and gentlemen. Griffith Femto is a multiple... This is just a fan page account. Now, the reason why this is important is a post from 2010. This meme is from the future. You cannot understand it yet. Now, this is a pretty old meme. I think it's a few months old at this point, but I'm actually jumping into it because, quite honestly, I saw this today just on Reddit, on Some Ordinary Gamer's Reddit page, and I was actually baffled. This was messing with my mind. Did someone discover time travel? Did a time traveler give us Among Us memes in the past? Because if you look closely, it says August 11, 2010. Yeah, that's pretty old. That's pretty sus. So, ladies and gentlemen, I went to Griffith Femto's original page, and initially it looks like, this person's just a fan of Berserk. You go down, a fan of the old anime, a little bit of yandere action, if you will. And then you go down and said, whoa, we're getting another Berserk movie. But then you get down, the meme from the future. And this one went a little viral on Facebook. It was shared like 39,000 times. But if you go even further, things get a little bit more sussy wussy. For instance, the one meme that we saw on Some Ordinary Gamer's Reddit was this twerking Among Us gif. Of course, you can see the voluptuous yellow character shaking that juicy ass booty. If you look at it, what really messed with me was June 3rd, 2007. Okay, so how is it that in 2007, somebody posted artwork from Among Us? Didn't make sense to me. I wondered if this was like the person behind the meme page was like an original developer for like Among Us. But even that didn't make any sense, because to develop Among Us assets, I'm sure nobody was developing Among Us ass, until I realized, whoa, maybe this goes a little deeper. Either somebody figured out how to timestamp Facebook's data values, or somebody's traveling through time. Now, to understand, even on this channel, Some Ordinary Gamers, yours truly had even discovered some form of time travel on YouTube through a channel known as Apex TV back in the day, who hasn't uploaded for 8 months, and I'm actually a little bit worried because Apex TV was god tier. This person was developing time travel videos to the point where they were talking to somebody from the year 4040. I don't even know if human beings are still going to be around till then, but this person was from that year. Apparently, that's what they claimed. In fact, this guy claims to have went to the year 3117, discovering good old Sonic the Hedgehog world's taken over, a magical world hijacked by that of the Mobius universe. He barely made it back just in time to give you that scary, scary prediction into the future. Now, we can always go into the times where we looked at a character known as John Titor, which I discussed on Deep Web Browsing years ago. A character who made a lot of assumptions, a lot of claims to what would happen in the future. A grand majority of those turned out to be nonsense. So, is time travel real? Well, if it is, Griffith Femto may have discovered the secrets. And what has he done with those secrets? What has he done with the mystery of time travel? Has he warned human beings about the impending future? War with Skynet? No. He went back and showed us Among Us asshole. In March 9, 2007, he actually told us on a specific day, August 29, 2021, Kanye West will drop Donda. And yes, Kanye West did in fact drop the Donda album. So clearly this person's predictions turned out to be more true than you could expect. Back in the day, Griffith Femto, in the year 2005, a very vintage year indeed, told us about Fat Bugs Bunny. to which he named him Big Chungus. Big Chungus is a character that was first mentioned in Metal Gear Solid 1. Towards the end of the game, you may remember Liquid telling Solid Snake that Big Chungus was in fact a character from the show Looney Tunes.
Are you familiar with Big Chungus? Big Chungus? Yes, Big Chungus, the world-renowned meme of an oversized cartoon rabbit. What does some dumb joke have to do with your plan? Everything, Snake!
Now, of course, Metal Gear Solid 1 was a game all about trying to become the superior meme status, trying to show that your dominant memes will rise amongst the recessive memes. Towards the end, Solid Snake comes to the realization that through his twin brother Liquid Snake, that Big Chungus is an example of what is a dominant meme. So, of course, you really have to play Metal Gear Solid to understand the real intricacies of this... to really understand the real intricacies of this scenario. Now, if you go even further down, what really gets me wild is February 29, 2004, when Among Us was first showcased gameplay-wise in this situation. Of course, you can see these posts getting more wilder. People are believing, whoa, how the hell did you get this in 2004, Deadface? But that was really the end. So, ladies and gentlemen, may I ask you, did this person discover time travel? Well, what's even wilder is Griffith Femto once posted in March 7, 2002, Endgame spoilers for the Marvel franchise. Now, how did this person post in 2002 when Facebook was discovered in 2004? Back in the day, U.S. Department of Defense, DARPA's division, for those of you who don't know, which discovers technologies headed towards the future, discovered something or was working on a project known as LifeLog. LifeLog, for a lot of people who don't know, simulates a situation where they were basically creating a cyber diary of willing participants. So, for instance, LifeLog, the all-remember cyber diary. Do you know those handheld personal digital assistants, Palm Pilots, that remind you of appointments, store phone numbers, and birthdays, tip you off to foibles of friends and vulnerabilities of enemies? I don't know that part of the Palm Pilot program, but tell me more, Daddy. Maybe that was the Apple Newton. God, I feel old. DARPA's LifeLog initiative is part of its cognitive computing research. The goal is to teach your computer to learn by your experience. So basically, for those of you who don't know, DARPA was developing a technology where they were basically cataloging the life of an entire user from basically birth to death using various capture methods, cameras, microphones, whatever you want to call it. Now, of course, while they kept this diary, the ultimate goal was to use it to replicate the human mind and create superior artificial intelligence. Of course, this project shut down in February of 2004, because if you could imagine the privacy concerns and implications. But you know what else happened in February of 2004? The birth of Facebook. Now, ladies and gentlemen, there's been a massive conspiracy theory where people believe that Facebook is just the evolution of DARPA's shutdown LifeLog program. Now, I would like to contend with this conspiracy theory, but that would be giving Mark Zuckerberg too much credit. I even jumped into the metaverse to understand what could be the reality of this situation. Is Mark Zuckerberg trying to use this technology to control us, catalog our lives, and use it to create a super world-bending artificial intelligence? No, because right now I'm on VR chat and I've realized that Facebook is nothing but a technology that willingly turns people into complete dipshits. Yeah, I'm never giving Mark that much credit. So then this brings down to the question, is this A, time traveling? Could be, I don't know. I mean, we learn new things about the world every day. Could it be somebody has found out a way to exploit Facebook servers and manipulate data values? Sure, maybe. Or number three, is this just the best shitpost of all time? That could be a very likely possibility. Now, I've seen people who genuinely gotten really weirded out about this, okay? So if you started looking around, this is a post that was made 4 days ago on r/memes, where they talked about Big Chungus. So of course, as you goes down, one person's like, that's a fucking time traveler, LMFAO. What? No, could it be time travel? See, I went to Facebook and I decided to understand just how one could achieve this level of shitposting. So if you go to Facebook, you have to find an old post that you made. I made one on November 7, 2016. Finally bought a house. Yeah, this was one of the last posts that I ever made on this website, alongside updating my actual profile picture into this disgusting looking cosplay of John Wick. Now, of course, in this, I've got a bunch of my friends commenting on this, okay? Congrats, dude! But what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this into something a little more sussy-wussy. So here I've got an image of Among Us Germa. Of course, he's got a little bit of an earthbound deal going on to it. But something you can do on Facebook right now to freak people out is you see where you have these three dots? Click on it and you can edit the post. So editing the post, first off, I'm just going to change it to only me so nobody sees me doing this. But then I'm going to add an image. I like Germa. So here I've got Germa going up over here, Among Us looking pretty sussy. But then I'm going to change this to
Shush.
And once I change it to sus, the entire world changes around. Oh, we're back in 2010, 2007, 2006. Why would Mark Zuckerberg literally allow people to do this? I don't know, but I can go so far back that I can even go beyond my parents getting married in 1991. So I'm going to hit Tuesday 1, January 91. My parents, they didn't even get married by this point. I wasn't even a sperm in my daddy's balls. But I'm going to save this and I'm going to change it to done. And yes, that will in fact process into a different post. In fact, now, on January 1st, 1991, I've created a post called Sus, and I have actually moved it around. So now you have Germa Sus on my page reporting from 1991. I would delete this post, but frankly, I don't care. I don't use Facebook that much, and if somebody in my family gets genuinely scared by it and unfriends me, well, that's just going to be how the cookie crumbles. But I wanted to show you this kind of a way because you too can achieve quality shitposting just by two simple changes. So yes, I don't know why Mark has allowed this. I honestly wonder if Mark is going to disable this from Facebook because the meme potential of this is through the roof. I also have to preface something for the legal team as well, and YouTube's TOS. Please don't actually use this to spread some sort of misinformation or do something wrong and naughty and against Facebook TOS, because that wouldn't be good. I figured I might as well just say this for legal and disclaimatory reasons, but yeah, if you just want to like tell everyone that you made Big Chungus the meme in the year 1776, go ahead, ladies and gentlemen, because you too can make that meme last as long as the United States of America. Follow your dreams, kiddos. Just don't do anything bad about it. That would be wrong. But yeah, I wanted to make this video because for the last 2 hours, I've genuinely been confused and I wondered, whoa, did somebody exploit Facebook? No, the reality is far more mundane. But now that your third eye has been opened, it's time for you to achieve ultimate shitpost status. So yeah, this is me, Mudahar, and if you like what you saw, please like, comment, and subscribe. Dislike if you dislike it. This is me, Mudahar, and I am